Hi friends, welcome back to Team Education. Friends, in this video we are solving problems on matrices. Given problem is verify given system of linear equations are consistent. If so, solve them. Friends, here you observe they are given linear system of equations. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and here the variables we have x, y, z. So we have a 3 unknowns. Okay, and they are given 3 equations. Now we have to verify these system of equations are consistent, okay, or not. If it is consistent, we have to find out the unknown values. Okay friends, here you observe how many variables are there? 3 variables. These are also called unknown values. Okay, first we have to write the given system of equations, means given linear system of equations, the matrix form, that is Ax is equal to b, where x is an unknown matrix, that is xyz, and a is here coefficient of xyz, coefficient matrix, b is here constant matrix. Okay, these are the constants. We have to verify the rank of the augmented matrix A, okay, and rank of A. If rank of AB which is equal to rank of A, then we can say the system is consistent. If it is not is equal to rank of A, then we can say inconsistent. Okay friends, if it is a consistent, there will be two options, two cases we have. If it is a consistent, we have to verify rank. Okay, if rank is equal to number of unknowns, here the number of unknowns are 3, in this case you will get a unique solution. If rank is less than n, means r is rank is less than 3, then we can say it as infinitely number of solutions, or you can say many solutions simply. Okay, infinitely many solutions. Now the given matrix we are solving, we are finding the unknown values if the system is consistent. Now I am writing the given system of linear equations into Ax is equal to b form, because right side terms what you have 8, 4, 0, so these are non-zero. Okay, you can say the system is non-homogeneous system of linear equations. So write in matrix form here the augmented matrix A, B. First you observe friends, here I am writing A and B. A is nothing but the coefficient of x, y, z, that is 2, minus 1, 3, next minus 1, 2, 1, minus 3, 1, minus 4, and here x is x, y, z, which is equal to, and the constant matrix what you have, constant right side equal part what I have, 8, 4, 0. Okay friends, now this is called coefficient matrix, this is called variable matrix or unknown matrix, and this is called constant matrix. Now I am writing augmented matrix. Augmented matrix means AB. So write down A and B also. A is 2, minus 1, 3, and this is 8. Next, minus 1, 2, 1, this is 4. Minus 3, 1, minus 4, this is. So friends, you can say the matrix is having here, A is having 3 rows and 3 columns. To find the rank of A, I am using elementary row operations. We will get a upper triangular matrix, and we are applying echelon form. So I am applying echelon form. First, round out the first diagonal element. What I have here? 2. By using this diagonal element, we have to make the below the diagonal elements are row. Okay. First, you observe friends, I am applying R2 tends to 2R2 minus R1. If I written, this is minus 2. Minus 2, minus 4. So write down here plus. Okay. 2R2 plus R1. What about R3? R3 tends to 2R3 plus 3R1. Okay. Here you observe what I am doing. I am multiplying 2. Here I am multiplying with 3. This is minus 6. This is plus 6. So this term will become 0. So are we applying the first row any operations? No. So write down the first row as it is. 2, minus 1, 3, 8. In the second row, what I am doing? I am multiplying 2 here and adding 1 here. Yes or no? So 2 minus 2 plus 1 plus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Next 2 into 2, 4. 4 minus 1 means 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. 8 plus 8 is 16. Okay, friends. Next, what we have? I am multiplying here 2 and here I am multiplying 3. Okay. Okay. Now 2 times of minus 3 means minus 6. Here you have a plus 6. Minus 6 plus 6 is 0. This is plus 2. This is minus 1. Plus 2 minus 1 means minus 1. Next, this is 2 times of minus 4 is minus 8. And 3 times of 3 is 9. So this is minus 8 plus 9 means 1. Next, 2 times of 0 is 0. Next, 3 times of 8 is 24. So this will be, okay friends, here you observe first diagonal element is this one. Below the diagonal elements are 0 or not? Yes. Now round up the second diagonal element. By using this second diagonal element, we have to make the below the diagonal element are 0. For that, what I am doing? This is, I am equating 0. For that, I am applying R3 tends to 3R3 plus R2. You observe friends, if I multiply 3, here you have minus 3 and add this one. So 3 minus 3 plus 3 will become 0. So here you observe friends, we are applying row operations for the third row only. So first row and the second row will be as it is. So I am writing first row and the second row 0, 3, 5, 16. Now I am multiplying 3, and for the second diagonal element am I multiplying anything? No, nothing but 1 only. Okay. Now 3 times of 0 plus 1 time of 0 is 0. Next, minus 3 plus 3. Minus 3 plus 3 is 0. 3 times of 1, 3. 3 plus 5, 8. Next, we have 3 times of 24. 3 times of 24 means 72 plus 1 times of 16 is 16. So if you are added, then you will have 88. Okay, friends, here you observe this is the matrix A. The third diagonal element is we have 8, which is non-zero. Okay, now this is in echelon form. In the echelon form, if there are any zero rows, that should be below the non-zero row. Yes or no? Here, is there any zero rows? No. So non-zero rows only we have. First condition, okay. In the second condition, zeros are in increasing order. In this case, you observe below the first one is non-zero element. So here there is no zero. This is the non-zero element in the second row. So here you have 1 0. This is the non-zero element in the third row. Here you have a 2 0. So satisfies the two conditions. So rank of a matrix in the echelon form is we have the number of non-zero rows. How many non-zero rows are there in the A? 1, 2, 3. What is mean by non-zero row? If there is any non-zero element in that row, then it is called non-zero row. So here you have 1, 2, 3. Rank of A is equal to 3 from the echelon form. And also rank of AB we have to verify. Rank of AB is also in the echelon form only. Yes or no? Now in this case, the number of non-zero rows 1, 2, 3. So here our rank of A is equal to rank of AB. Therefore, you can say the system AX is equal to B is consistent. Okay, na? Whenever it is consistent, it has a solution. How many types of solutions we have? Two types of the solutions. One is R is equal to N condition. Another one is R less than N. What is R here? R is equal to 3. Number of unknowns are how many we have? X, Y, Z. So you can say rank 3 and the unknowns also 3. Therefore, you can say the system is unique solution, containing unique solution. When you can get an infinite number means if rank is less than 3. Less than 3 means it may be 2 or 1 or 0. Okay, na? Now here you observe friends, we have a unique solution. How to find the solutions? First, we have to write the augmented matrix into AX is equal to B. After that, we have to go for back substitution method. So first, I am writing the matrix A. 2, minus 1, 3, 0, 3, 5, 0, 0, 8. Okay. Next, what about the X here? Unknown matrix or constant, unknown matrix or variable matrix, that is X, Y, Z or X, Y, Z. Now, constant matrix, what you have here? 8, 16, 88. Now go for back substitution. In the back substitution, you see friends how we are doing? 0 into x plus 0 into y plus 8 into z. So 8z. This is called back substitution. Okay, now. Now 8z is equal to what? 88, which implies z value is equal to 11. Okay, z value we have. Next, coming to the y value means go for the second row. 0 into x plus 3 into y plus 5 into z, which is equal to 16. Okay, friends. Now, whatever the z value? 11. So, 3y plus 55, which is equal to 16. So, 3y is equal to 16 minus 55. So, 3y, which is equal to 39. Okay, from this, you can say which 9, which 39? Negative 39. Okay, from this, y is equal to, you can say minus 13. Whatever the z previously we have? 11. Next, one more row is there. So 2 into x minus 1 into y plus 3 into z, which is equal to what? 8. So I don't know the value of x. I know the value of y. What is the y? Minus 13. So it will become minus of minus plus 13 plus 3 into z. What is the z value we have? 11. So 3 times of 11 means 33, which is equal to 8. So 2x is equal to 8 minus, this is what, 46. 8 minus 46. So 2x, which is equal to minus 38. Therefore, x is equal to minus 19. Now, I got the values of x, y, z. Tell me, what is the x value here? Minus 19. And y value is here? Minus 13. And z value is here? 11. So, you can say values of x, y, z are this. Is it clear for everyone? How to verify the given matrix is consistent or inconsistent? If it is consistent, how to solve the problem in this method? In the next method, we will discuss one more problem when we have a unique solution and also infinitely many solutions. Thank you for watching this video.